Hey, it's Jo. So for today's video, we are going to eat Filipino spaghetti. As you can see, sobrang dami nito. Si Motherhood kasi yung naglagay, nag-setup niyan. Siya din yung nagluto. Tumulong lang ako sa paghihiwa because it's her birthday. Birth month, actually. Kasi tapos na yung birthday niya. So ito yung second batch ng pagluluto namin ng spaghetti. And we made it extra. Ilagay namin siya ng hipon at saka ng what do you call this? Bacon and hot dog na din. And of course, ang cheese ng bayan, Eden cheese. So let's start. Super excited ako kumain today because for some reason, gutom ako and bumili ako ng bagong tinidor. Binili ko lang to sa Miniso kasi nagpunta ako sa SM kahapon. May ginawa akong mga errands. So, let's start. Sobrang dami nito. Grabe. Grabe yung plating ng nanay ko. Alam mo yung pang isang pamilya. Family size. Yung nilagay niya. Para daw maganda yung aesthetic, kumbaga. Ang sarap. Naku, gumulong na yung hotdog. Sobrang sarap ng hipon. The best. Mama, ang sarap po. Happy birthday, mama po. Sarap.
Alokin mo si Lady Ka at si
Pepe. Usually kasi yung Filipino spaghetti, wala naman talaga siyang hipon. Pero may stock kasi kami ng frozen na shrimp. In fairness. Siyempre, tender, juicy na hotdog. Sobrang sarap. Kung nandito yung mga pamangkin ko, for sure. Wipe out to. Favorite nila yung spaghetti. Hi, Ike. Hi, Keisha. Hi, Carlene. Gusto niyo spaghetti? Sobra niyang sarap. Mama, sobrang sarap. Ang sarap. Not because she's my mom. And it's her birthday. Pero masarap talaga. Ganong condensed sa kaya? May condensed na, may iba pa. Yummy. Obviously, sobrang dami nito. Hindi ko siya mauubos ng isang upuan lang, pero sarap. Siyempre, aking bagong favorite locally na mango juice. Na favorite na rin ni Mudrakels kasi na lasang mangga talaga siya, hindi siya lasang gamot. The best spaghetti. Nakakaloka. Hindi ako sobrang gutom. Pero for some reason, I can't stop eating. Sobra talaga niyang sarap. Feeling ko busog na ako, pero gusto ko pa rin kumain. But yeah, for today's video, we are going to talk about the disappearance of a young girl. Her name is Bong Siribun. She's from Thailand, pero nag-migrate siya at yung kanyang family sa Melbourne, Australia. So I will insert the audio here. In June 2011, in Melbourne, Australia, 13-year-old Bong Siribun was walking to school, as she did every morning, when she disappeared into thin air. No one saw her or heard anything, and Bong has not been seen or heard from since. Each morning, 13-year-old Siriacorn Bong Siribun would make the short 10-minute walk from her Melbourne home to her school. So yung school ni Bong ay sobrang lapit lang sa kanilang bahay. On the way to her school, she'd met up with her friends. Nakakasalubong niya sa daan and binabati niya. So sabay-sabay silang paglalakad papasok ng school. But on the morning of June 2, 2011, Bong was walking alone. It was Thursday, like any other school day. Pagkatapos mag-breakfast ng egg rice soup, Bong left her house, which she shared with her stepfather, Fred, her mother, Vanida, and elder sister, Siriporn, also known as Pang, at about 8:30 a.m. Fred just actually finished a night shift at a local factory. And he was in the back room. He heard Bong na nagpaalam sa nanay niya. And she said, "Bye mom, see you later," quote unquote. So according sa mga reports, Bong crossed the LC Street where her family had mostly lived since nag-migrate sila from Thailand to Australia 4 years earlier. And she headed east. 3 doors up, merong neighbor's dog na kumahol sa kanya, and she run. Maybe because she's scared of dogs or nagulat siya. And a neighbor saw her in her blue and white uniform and blue raincoat. That's the first sighting of Bong after niyong umalis ng bahay. So after nung LC Street, Bong headed in Albert Avenue. Albert Avenue is a congested main road which Bong used to cross every morning before turning left into a much quieter road named Harcourt Road. It was a little way along doon sa road na yon ay magle-left turn siya into another street which was a cul-de-sac which led to the high school's back gate. So, sa back gate dumaan si Bong. Someone reported seeing her in Harcourt Road at around 8:55 a.m. And itong Harcourt Road ay 130 meters lang away from the back door of her school. But Bong didn't make it to school on June 2nd, 2011. And since then, no one has seen her. Bong's real name was Siriyakorn Siribun. I'm sorry about my pronunciation. Pinopronounce ko lang siya by syllables. So, I'm not really sure if it's really Siriyakorn Siribun because hindi naman ako marunong mag-Thai. So, let's just say it's Siriyakorn Siribun. But she was known by everyone as Bong, B-U-N-G, as her nickname. Ang sabi ng mga teachers sa school ni Bong, she has always been an enthusiastic, diligent student. So, nung hindi pumasok si Bong, inisip nila na baka may sakit si Bong and decided na wag na lang pumasok that day. Her mother and stepfather had said goodbye to her at about 8:30 a.m. And they didn't have any reason to believe na wala sa school si Bong. After school, Bong was always home on time at around 3:40 p.m. Nasa bahay na siya and never siyang nalilate. And I believe sa edad niya na 9 years old at the time, wala naman siyang ibang pupuntahan kundi school at bahay lang. According to the investigators, at around 4 p.m, Bong's mother, Vanida, wondered out loud where her daughter was because Bong was never late, ever, or kung malilate man, magpapaalam kung saan pupunta. And then, the phone rang. Bong's stepfather, Fred Pattison, answered the phone. It was Bong's friend, Jamai, or Jamay. She wanted to tell Bong about something that was planned for school tomorrow. And this was how Bong's parents learned that she didn't make it to class that day. That's when they started to panic. For 9 years that Bong has been missing, yung mga pulis, nangatok sila sa lahat ng bahay, more than 1,000 doors, to try to investigate and determine what happened to Bong. They interviewed a lot of people in the community. Nag-interview sila kung nakita ba nila, and doon nga nila nalaman na may mga witnesses. And doon sa investigation na yun, they confirmed someone saw a girl matching Bong's description inside a white station wagon around 15 minutes after she left her home. According to the witness, the girl was looking through the back window, watching oncoming traffic. Ang sabi ng witness, yung driver daw was a Caucasian man, aged in his early 40s to 60s, with large tattoos on his arms. However, police could not confirm the sighting as it was conflicting with another witness's statement. So may nakakita kay Bong siguro dito sa left side and then sa right side may nakakita din sa kanya, pero hindi nagmamatch yung kanilang statement. Ang sabi ng stepfather ni Bong, although hindi daw ganun ka streetwise si Bong, she always knew to be wary of strangers. Diba nga, laging sinasabi, stranger danger. Lalo na sa panahon ngayon. What more pa before, diba? And she would never get into a car with someone she didn't know. 9 years old na siya ng mga panahong to. So, may isip na siya. But still, bata pa rin. Minor de edad. In 2013, a 24-year-old man was arrested after he claimed that he hit and kicked Bong while driving in his car on the morning she disappeared. According to him, he panicked and disposed of her body at a local reserve. So yung mga police, nag-search sila doon sa reserve, pero they didn't find anything or any remains. And this man was released. I don't know kung anong nasa utak ng lalaking ito para umamin sa krimen na hindi niya ginawa or ginawa niya, pero yung tinuro niya na place kung saan niya nilagay, quote-unquote, yung remains is mali. So yung task force na sinet up para imbestigahan yung disappearance ni Bong was shut down as its leads dried up. So dahil wala ng leads na nakukuha yung mga pulis, shut down yung task force na naghahanap kay Bong. Bong's friends spoke of the pain of not knowing what happened to her. Her close friend named Taylor said that she struggled with her decision not to walk with Bong to school on the morning of June 2. Ang sabi ni Taylor, quote-unquote, "I remember it clearly as day, walking with my brother, and he asked if I wanted to walk with Bong." And hindi daw niya alam kung bakit sinabi niya na no. Ang sabi niya, nire-regret niya na hindi siya sumabay kay Bong sa paglalakad, and that it's really hard to live with it. Masabi naman ng isa niyang kaibigan, si Jamay or Jamay, na making that phone call to Bong's house made it clear that she was missing. And according to her, she basically told Bong's parents that she was missing. And she felt responsible for a lot of years. And she said that Bong would always be her best friend. Para naman sa pamilya ni Bong, ang sabi nila, yung uncertainty daw kung ano ang nangyari kay Bong has created a life in quote-unquote limbo. Her grieving mother moved back to Thailand because she finds it too hard to live in the Melbourne home she had shared with her youngest child. But Fred still lived in the same home. According to Fred, they want some sort of news, any news about Bong. Good or bad man, gusto nilang makatanggap ng leads, and they still believe that Bong is coming back one day, and they will see her again one day, quote unquote. Even her friends are also united by their hope of seeing Bong again. Ang sabi ni Taylor, "Every day, I'm still hoping that she's okay. You want to know that these past 9 years haven't just been the worst 9 years of her life," quote unquote. There's still a $1 million reward for information leading to the conviction for Bong's disappearance or any information para mahanap siya. Bong is described as being of Thai origin, approximately 154 centimeters tall, thin build, with long dark hair and brown eyes. If you have any information regarding a missing person or regarding Bong, please contact Crime Stoppers on 1-800-333-000. As you've heard, until now, wala pa rin leads kung nasaan si Bong Siribun, and it's been 9 years. If she's still with us, she would have been 18 or 19 years old. So yeah, medyo malungkot yung story natin for today. But still, I believe meron pa rin naman tayong makukuha na lesson. And let's pray for her family na magkaroon sila ng closure. And na sana, as soon as possible, makakuha sila ng information. Because lagi nga sinasabi ng mga nasa true crime community na someone knows something, imposibleng wala. Kasi may witnesses naman na nakakita sa kanya. Yun nga lang, yung iba, hindi nagtutugma yung kanilang statements, pero absolutely, may nakakita sa kanya nung araw na yun, nung papasok siya ng school. So yeah, sobrang busog na ako. And nakita nyo naman kanina, puno ito, as in, pang pamilya talaga, family size na spaghetti. But yeah, thank you so much guys for watching. Please like and subscribe. I hope to see you on my next video. Please stay safe, stay home, and be a little kinder. God bless you all. Bye!